All right, family, peace, peace, peace. This is Brother Hot Tim coming at you live and direct, and you are now listening to Giami Journey Radio. Oh, and video. And today is the Daily Toast. It's the morning of Daily Toast. We're going to lift up our glass and salute our ancestors, but we got to have a talk. I should have did it yesterday. We're going to have a talk today. So this is a Daily Toast, and of course you know this is a Heart of a Simba production. Where we strive, 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 and this morning we may have to blow up. We're going to blow up some paradigms. All right, fam. Oh, man, I should have turned off the speaker. So I apologize to those that might be listening live on Giami Journey. What's up, Brother Hazen? Welcome, Miss Sheila Tarpe. Alright, for some reason I don't think Facebook is allowing me to get over 4 people, because you know, people be checking in and I don't know whether y'all be falling off or you just look for a second because I be taking too long. You know, I apologize. Well, I don't apologize for that shit. We got to have some real talk, right? Today is Emoja. And family, I was gonna sleep in. Yeah, I was up late last night. I had to go to the hookah shop because I had to review some of the footage that we did. I told you we were about to come out with the actual video equipment. Right now I'm just using a little HD camera, and not that it's not valuable to me, but the equipment that these brothers is working with is on a whole nother level, and we're gonna bring you some quality stuff. Quality, or as Brother Hotton said, some quality shit, right? We're not playing, right? And I was driving home. The thought hit me. So I was reading from Amos Wilson's The Falsification of African Consciousness, Eurocentric History, Psychiatry, and the Politics of White Supremacy, or as I like to call it, white nationalism. Fuck the, you know what I'm saying? Because when we say the term supremacy to our kids, supremacy has the root of super, you know what I'm saying? Or Uber Man, Superman, and we need to kind of erase that shit. We got to change the story. Right? The story is not supremacy. The story is nationalism. Right? White nationalism or white tribalism or whatever the fuck you want to call it. Everything else but supremacy, because it's not that. It's not that. Right? So, I'm reading my man Amos Wilson. And Amos Wilson has a small part in here called, and I know y'all ready for the toast, but family, I have to get this out. Why Study History. It's a very short piece, and I'm going to read it. Alright? He says, the study of history cannot be a mere celebration of those who struggle on our behalf. We must be instructed by history and should transform history into concrete reality, into planning and development, into the construction of power and ability to ensure our survival as a people. If not, Black History Month becomes an exercise in the inflation of egos. Hold on. The ancestor deserves a crackle. I ain't even getting to my shit yet. But it's like, it's like Amos Wilson is reaching out from the grave and just pulling us by our collar, right? You know what I'm saying? It becomes an exercise that cuts us further off from reality. Ironically, we now see even other people who are not our friends joining us in this celebration. Now listen, let me get my thunder ready. Y'all, listen to this shit. Which means, well, let me start that we now see even other people who are not our friends joining us in the celebration, which means that they must see in it some means of protecting their own interests. and see in it something that works for them and possibly against us. If they can celebrate our history, if they can celebrate our history and see it as something positive, then it means that we are not using it in a revolutionary sense. They do not see our study of it as a threat to their power. If we are not studying it in a way that is a threat to their power, then we are studying it incorrectly. And our celebration of it is helping to maintain us in a state of deception. So let us make sure that we look at the study of history in a light such that it advances our interests, not inflates our egos and blinds us to reality. Now let's look at European history and what I call historiography and oppression, its function and outcome. By historiography, I refer to the writing of history. We see in many of today's newspapers and popular media, this is back in the early 90s, that many people are complaining about the state of the study of history. In fact, that is not being studied that much in high school, or that Western civilization is not being studied enough. Now we see a number of universities and colleges reinstituting as part of their core curricula the study of Western civilization. I'm sure some of us are familiar with the controversy that are going on because the feminist movement is saying that feminist history should be interjected into the study of so-called Western civilization. Of course, African history advocates are also demanding that African history and non-Western civilization be included in that area. So I'm going to stop right there, right? But we cannot allow our study of our history to become a dance with fantasy. As African people, we have had a long-standing rule that we must learn to face reality. This is in the laws of Maya. This is in the initiation system that we use. Learning to distinguish the real from the unreal. Family, right? Now, what really started bothering me about this shit is that we really don't look at history. And because we really don't look at history, we don't really understand what's happened, right? Because it's never been a resurgence of white nationalism. The shit has always been here. Because we got to understand that it's based on fear and it's based on guilt. Guilt. You know what I'm saying? How could we have done such a thing to another human being? So they have to take your humanity. They have to try to strip you of your humanity because there's no way that you can do another human being like that and be human yourself. So deep down, they feel guilty about this shit. So they have to do more shit to prove that we're not human. You know what I'm saying? See, and a lot of people don't understand that they're not saying that we're below human, right? Because this is where the fear piece come in. They believe deep down that we are above human, because there is no way that we could have survived the shit that they put us through. And hence comes the fear. Hence comes the fear. How in the fuck can you forgive us? Y'all motherfuckers is living with us. Y'all living amongst us. And it's terrifying after they start learning some of the shit that they done did. Family, do you realize that in my life, in my daily libations, I only could go back my grandfather's grandfather, my grandfather's father, my grandfather, and my mother's generation. At the most, five, including me, five generations. On my father's side, I only could go back three. Do we understand the fact that through trauma of people who has kept history for thousands of years in a verbal fashion can only go back 5 years. You know what I'm saying? I can remember all types of facts and shit. You mean to tell me that somebody like me can only remember five names? There's a trauma, right? And this trauma draws fear from the others. Because how could we do this? And I need West Asians to understand that they're not by themselves, because Central Asians and East Asians been trying to treat us like shit too. As a matter of fact, the Central Asians have been some of the worst motherfuckers dealing with us. And it's a lot of people that got to pay, right? Now, so in studying history, we have to be able to deal with the real, right? And part of the reality that I have to constantly deal with is being honest with our children, right? We have to learn to be honest with our children about our history and about the struggle that we are in. We have to, and I know it's going to bother some of y'all, right? But we have to be bold enough and brave enough to get our children to see what happened to us and why they are where they are, rather than lying to them. Because I mean, I know I done did this before. I know I keep talking about this, but it really bothers me that a lot of our children don't understand that they are one paycheck away from possibly being absolutely homeless. I try to let my kids know. My daughter's like, they, you know, 911 just passed, and Gina was in school, and I didn't interfere with the class, but you know, they got her all hyped up about this whole 911 shit, to where Gina came back and scared Sasha. And Sasha was riding the back of the car, and she was like, "What's the date?" I said, September 12th. Is that 911? I said, "No, that's one day after 911. Because I don't want the builders to fall. Well, since the builders didn't fall, can we go to New York?" And Sasha is in love with going to, she want to go to California. And I have to look at my babies, and I have to be like, "Baby, you know what I'm saying? At this point in time, your daddy can't take you to New York. I would love to, you know what I'm saying? But at this point in time, I can't take you to California. Why? Because I ain't got no goddamn money. I ain't got no money. Why you ain't got no money?" Then we have to get into the history, family. Then we have to sit down and we have to discuss the history and the reason why I don't have wealth to draw on, because we're starting with, in a sense, with my generation. Why? Is it because we wasted our money? Is it, you know what I'm saying? I mean, you know what I'm saying? And we got to really have this discussion with our kids. See, because this is the fact of the matter, right? Our children are very creative. Our children are very powerful. They have a lot of energy, and when they see a problem, they go about solving it. But because we lying to them, the problems that they solve are the same problems that a lot of these young West Asian children and Central Asian children are working on, because they think that they are in the same place that some of these kids are, when in fact they are not. We need to be honest with our children so our children can have a platform to build from and start creating the wealth and coming up with the ideas and going to school with a sense of seriousness. Our children don't buy into school because they don't believe they need that shit. Because some of these kids actually believe that they got an inheritance coming. And some of you parents need to be honest with your children. Baby, you wearing your inheritance. Really. See, because now they can go back and they can actually look and be like, "Damn, we got some ground to catch up on." And so we can start working together as the families. We can start working together as tribes to really start building, because now a need for unity starts to arise. Do you understand? See, right now, our people don't believe we need unity. I believe that if I pull myself up by my own bootstraps, you know what I'm saying? If I could pull my illusionary boots up, you know what I'm saying? That's, see, motherfuckers because illusions, illusions are real enough for our ancestors to have mentioned this shit in initiation. Do we not understand this shit? Do we not understand that we got people with legacies of over 10,000 years, motherfuckers watching human beings studying who we were? Do we not understand that some shit would not have made it to us if this shit was not real? Our ancestors understood that illusions are real. Illusions are something that could really fuck you up. This is why, in order for you to really get the higher levels of learning, family, you had to be snapped out of all of the illusions that you had in your life. And it's not fair for us to allow our children to carry on the fucking illusions that we are dealing with. Brother Kwame say, I to the young adult Ghanaian man. He doesn't understand why his mom and aunts, and especially many of the Ghanaian women, dislike white so much. He is so unknowing of our history that he says he would suffer the separation of him from his mother, the hookup. He says he will suffer the separation of him from his mother to hook up with a white girl. I attempt to reintroduce him to his own history so he can at least understand his mother's and aunt's sentiments. That should have sentiments. See, that's their fucking illusion. And we do not understand that they're playing on. See, part of the magic that we had was we taught motherfuckers how to put spells. You know what I'm saying? A spell is not the shit that you see on TVs where motherfuckers say abracadabra, hubba bubba. You know what I'm saying? And shit happens. No. It's about making a motherfucker see the unreal. And the only person that can make somebody see the unreal is somebody that's grounded in reality. Do you understand? The only way I could create something called money is because I'm grounded in reality. I can use your belief to finance my dreams. I can use your labor to build up my dreams. Brother Kwame said they don't understand we are at war. And that's the point. When we start teaching them the fact, family, we are at war. This is why Brother Hot Tim can get up at 4:15 in the motherfucking morning and toast up our ancestors. This is why we have to do this shit. We don't go to war the way other motherfuckers go to war. We don't learn how to fight wars like they fought. We understand that war happens on 5 levels for us. Intuitionally, mentally, spiritually, emotionally, spiritually, and physically. I'm waging a mental war right now, discussing with y'all. When we lift up our glass, we're raising the intuitional war and we're raising the spiritual war. And by us working out and taking care of our body and drinking our water, we starting the physical war. These motherfuckers have been attacking us. You do not even understand that they are willing to sacrifice their own. They not only attacking you, they're attacking their own. So what? What do you expect? What do you expect? How do you beat somebody like that if you're not grounded in reality? If your children is running around, if they're running around thinking that everything is okay, and they think it's okay because we act like it's okay. Do you understand? This is what kept many of us from running, because we believed that we was okay. We stayed on the plantation because we believed that it was okay, and we believed that it was normal, that we believed that that was a normal part of life. Do you not understand that the human condition looks for opportunities to conserve energy, and if that means keeping your ass an illusion, it will do that? That this right here, this body, the intuition, the mind, and the spirit all serves you? And I said spirit, because many of us is getting caught up and thinking that the spirit is us. Come on, family. Come, let's evolve. Let's evolve. We got to evolve, family. It's bigger. I mean, it's all that shit. It's all of it. Brother Kwame, Sister Shet says, speak that. Brother Kwame said, I spent five hours at a time with this brother teaching him statistics and the war of use of words in his learning. But at this point, he is only beginning to understand that I mean by how they use words to trip brothers like him up on SAT, ACT exam. He doesn't know how Dr. Asa here showed what I'm trying to explain to him. Because all that shit is not real to him. We have not made it real. See, because you got to understand, we're living in a time where it's so deep. Okay? You know what I'm saying? You know, because Black Panther about to come out, and Hollywood allowed that shit to go out. We're living in a post-racial society. Didn't you know that, Kwame? Sishet, don't you understand that shit? We're living in a post, you see what I'm saying? Delusions, the non-reality that's being forced upon our children. We're living in a post-racial society. You know what I'm saying? I have white people who have spent more time with me than my parents had. Is it? You know what I'm saying? You go to the elementary school and see who's populating a lot of classrooms that your children are in. So of course I would forsake my family so that I can pursue love. Because love is an individual endeavor. Just like wealth is an individual endeavor. This is the shit that we are allowing our children to feast on. So it's no wonder that many of us will spend our latter years in famine. Come on, family. Come on, family. My elder, Mama Malika, told me a long time, she said, you know what, baby, love ain't shit. I said, well, what? She said, love ain't shit. You sitting up here pursuing love, trying to get married. You need to be pursuing business. Like, oh, fuck that. I'm looking, there you go with that old. That ain't even revolutionary shit. What is you talking about? Love ain't shit. You marrying for the wrong reason. You marrying, like, you know what I'm saying? You got flu-like symptoms and you think that shit is love. What you think is love is love. That ain't shit. You're not marrying for reality. I said, what? Wow. Elders be dropping shit that we be missing. You know what I'm saying? Because of the brainwash. And it's like, a lot of our elders be having patience. But sometimes you got the one. See, but, you know, if she would have been any stronger, she would have chased me away at that point in time. I wouldn't have had the experience with her that I had. So sometimes our elders have to have experience with us and let us go through our fucking foolishness. Because if not, they sure would chase us into the arms of the enemies. Because some of the shit that they would tell us would be so out there for us at that point in time that we would not be around. Brother Kwame says, discerning right from wrong, discerning the real from the wrong is quite a challenge for a young. And it's not quite a challenge for a young, it's more of a challenge for the adults, because the issue is that the adults is coming up distinguishing the real from the unreal. You know what I'm saying? The stream distinguishing right from wrong. You know what I'm saying? They'll follow the motto. So they ain't hard for the children. It's hard for the fucking adults. It's us. It's us. You know what I'm saying? That's what's fucked up. Think about that, family. It's not the children. It's not hard for them. They imitate what we do. Two of my children are teachers. They spend a great deal of time breaking bad habits on our children before they can teach them. You know what I'm saying? We got some horrible habits. My sister Janice told me maybe 2 years ago when we started doing the folk tales for grown folk, or it might have been a tribal quote. She said, it's impossible to teach a child that hasn't been raised. We're not raising them. We're not You know what I'm saying? When you allow a motherfucker to be steeped in illusion, you're not raising them. You're not raising them. Look at how the laws are structured. It's structured to keep your child in illusion until he runs up against the system. Him or her runs up against the system, then they get reality. You know what I'm saying? You whoop your child, you go to jail. They whoop your child goes to jail. Hell, they whoop your child in jail. Then they talk about how you didn't spend the time with your child that you need. Fucking illusions. Magic. Wordplay. Right? We think of magic as something deep. Shit is very simple. Wisdom. That's all it is. Wisdom is like everything else. It's neutral. Until you decide on which way you're going to use it. And we got to understand that people will use the information for their people. Just like laws are created to protect the future of those that create the law. Then you have not created any laws. This is why anything goes in our community. Laws require individuals that are willing to protect them and to make sure that the laws stay. We can't do that, right? Or we're not supposed to do that. See, because that right there will have motherfuckers all over this planet shaking in their boots. All over the planet. Oh, they woke up. You know what I'm saying? Like people call it being on code. You call it whatever the fuck you want. It's about laws. It's about do's and don't do's. It's about distinguishing the real from the unreal, right from wrong. And understand, right? Because, you know, because people waiting for the long arc of justice. The only time the arc of justice is long is when you depend on other motherfuckers to provide you with justice. That's the only time the arc is long, because I don't want to give you justice that's going to take away from my children. Do you understand? That's why the arc of justice is long. Because you're waiting on somebody else who has dependence on them. It's sort of like when people tell me, brother, I tell the world is coming to the end. I'm like, fuck you. Fuck whatever you believe in. Because the world will not come to an end while I'm on this motherfucker. Because I will fight tooth and nail. I don't give a fuck who pops up talking about it's time for the end of the world when I got children on this motherfucking planet. How can you be a parent and be satisfied with the fucking world ending? How can you do that? That's brainwashing. That's unreality. That's some crazy shit. How can you accept the fact that these motherfuckers have conquered this motherfucking planet? So put your ass in a subservient position and be satisfied with the fact that the world is coming to an end while you get to look at your baby. Man, something wrong with that. Something wrong with that. So let's toast these ancestors. Not under my watch, man. No. You know what I'm saying? Can't be. Not under my watch. In the world, while my babies are still. Baby still walking in the world. That's okay. Because an old book said something. Do you not understand that the Western mind has to develop an end? Because all the fuckery that they have been involved with, do you not understand that the Asian mind has to come up with an end? Let's say the Western Asian. Central Asian, because of how fucked up life has been for them and how many people they have fucked up, they have to have the world come to an end. Y'all don't understand that? And we buy into that? We buy into it? Do you not understand that most of our cultures did not have an ending until we ran into these motherfuckers? So, people will be talking about the world coming to end, why Gina, Cleve, and Sasha, and Wisdom, and my grandchildren. You know, I went skating with my kids, and my granddaughter showed up. And, you know, and I got to see them really enjoying themselves. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, it was skating. It's nothing big. But the feeling that they were able to go to a place and really enjoy themselves, and I was able to get out there with them, and I'm able to do stuff like this with my kids and my grandkids. You know what I'm saying? To see all these families come together. You know what I'm saying? It's a powerful thing. You know what I'm saying? It's something that I'm willing to die to maintain. And I know a lot of us, you know what I'm saying, we're not supposed to think like that. You know what I'm saying? We're supposed to just let the enemy come in and do what the fuck they want. Because that's the divine way. Maybe I'm above the penalty fan. You know? Because oftentimes one of the things that a lot of people that don't really follow the myths, you know what I'm saying? You look at the myths from a victim perspective rather than a victor's perspective. You look at our myths, all the myths, from a perspective of a slave, not just us. Those deities had human emotions. They were very human in how they dealt with shit. And look all across the culture. Saying, who are you talking about? Who are you talking about? You know what I'm saying? We had deities with wrath. We had deities with forgiving. You know what I'm saying? Are you talking about us? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Yeah, we created the myths so that we can have a better understanding of what's going on. I mean, I'm not knocking what you believe in, but I'm just saying, you have to kind of change the perspective of how you look at it, because some of this shit will not be okay once you really start looking at it. If you kind of messed up and become an ancestor and not really realize that you just giving away all your shit. You mean I could have kept that? You know what I'm saying? This long arc of justice? No. And I'm going to say this too. This might be kind of, you know what I'm saying? The world can't come to an end until they cut my people a check. Bring it to an end after you cut the goddamn check. Right? You know what I'm saying? The resources, however you want to do it. This motherfucker cannot end until the books is balanced. You know what I'm saying? Until the books is balanced. You can't do it. Can't do it. My eye is on my timeline, right? You know what I'm saying? Set my eyes on the timeline. My eye, can we ask for a balance before these motherfuckers start talking about them in the world? You know what I'm saying? Deities have personality traits like we do. Each one has a positive and negative attribute. Most people don't understand that. They understand it all. They understand that we're talking about ourselves. They don't understand that. You know what I'm saying? We told stories about ourselves. You know, you crazy for thinking that shit, man. But I tell you, crazy for thinking that shit. But it's cool. So we lift up our glass. We toast the creator by whatever name you choose to call it. Even if you look in the mirror and say, Ashe, right? You lift up that glass and you say, Ashe. From there, we move on to our personal ancestors. We call on those that came before us. We call on the past so that we can use those lessons to build a true legacy for our children, a legacy built on reality, built on truth and built on right. You understand what I'm saying? Lift up our glass, right? And we salute those ancestors and realize that we're standing upon their shoulders. And if we're sitting on their, standing on their shoulders doing absolutely nothing, we become an unnecessary burden. So we lift up our glass and we call on our ancestors. We give them strength. We call on our ancestors to feed them. We call on our ancestors to send them energy if that makes you feel a little bit more comfortable. You know what I'm saying? And we ask for them to be present with us as we walk through this day of Umoja, seeking out, looking for unity. Because out there, we may just be missing. So we lift up our glass and we call on them. I start calling my line, y'all start calling y'all. Miles Brown, Miss Ann, I've been texting her Davis on the line, saying you welcome to Philly, Georgia, and we walk it. Chris, if I'm guessing, I mean, I'm a Chris. I've seen the news by Bleeding Wild, Margaret Ellis, Rosh Ellis, Cecil Ellis, Miles Brown, Jimmy Gaines, Barbara Twiggs, Katie Ellis, Nikki Ellis, Tamon Jones, Jeremiah Tappet, Montague Pippen Hill, John Law, Tony Clark, Terrell Dunbar, Dr. Marianne Williams, Coach Kamau, Elder Donaldson, Elder Harrison, Elder Farmer, Elder Millie Dixon. Noma X, Pat Mile Rock, the elders that were celebrated, Kwanzaa, I had a book available. We're going to lift up, we're going to toast and release it. Ashe. Right from there, we toast this moment. Right now, we are in Umoja. Umoja, for those that don't know, is unity, which is one of the principles that we will set our guidance system on finding and searching out. So that when people are talking about, we're this unified, we can look at points of where we have unity, you know what I'm saying, and start building from there, rather than feeling that we have to build from scratch. Is the demonic principles for the day is truth. Color violet, the hermetic law, which I'm wrestling with at this point in time, is mentalism, the hermetic law, mentalism, and basically it states that all is mental, which I have a problem with now. That's just me, you know what I'm saying? I need to kind of get up out of mind, you know what I'm saying? It's a little bit more than that, not more than that. Males born on this day, Bojo. Female born on this day is Adawa. Emotional Masturbation Circles, the African Center, Cultural Virtues and Value System. If you don't want to look for those principles, here's some more. Wolof, Tawanga, Sense of Hospitality, and Khan. Once again, it's true. Course in Mayadas, true. In traditional Yoruba, the principle is suru, patience. We lift it up. Sister Maya, okay, we lift it up. I'll read that in a second. We lift it up and we say, Shay, the present moment, because in the moment is our power, right? So we are able to harness the energy of the past. You can understand, by us studying history, by us recalling history, it creates an energy that we are able to project and use in the moment to also project into the future. Right, right now, we are at a central point. You know what I'm saying? We don't need the past. We don't need the past nor future. We are in between. We are in between. And we are the bridge that allows the energy from the past to move to the future. And if we're wise enough, we can use that energy to create what we will, family. Right? So we move to our future generations, our children, our children's children, on to infinity, right? We tell our children the truth. We live with our children the truth, right? We let them see what's real. As painful as it may be, because that pain will cause them to take shit a little bit more seriously and start building. We shouldn't have to wait for our children, especially in the situation here. We shouldn't have to wait for our children to mature when they're 18, 19, 20 years old. We gotta get up out of that shit, because by that time, it's too late for many. So we lift up our glass for our children. We pour for them now. We drink for them now so they can pour for us later. That they're able to do from this side of the wall, from this side of the grave. So we lift up. We say, shame. May I touch you and any of the issues that you may have, that you may be facing. May your ancestors make the way smooth. Now knock the problems out the way, because it's through the problems that we get the wisdom, and it may be that very problem that your ass is trying to avoid that may be able to catapult you to where you need to be. Or maybe even be an experience that you can share with others that can help us move together as a family. So we lift up our glass and we say, Ashe. 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 I toast you, family. I toast you, I toast you, I toast you. We say, I wish you peace, power, joy, and 100 years. We want to make sure it's still recorded. Sister Miles says, deities have personality traits like we do. Each one has positive and negative attributes. Most people don't understand that. We read that one. Then she says, it's irritating as fuck for people who have names and do not do the work to understand what that name means or take on the power and responsibility of that name. Because we honestly have fallen into the myth that says names don't matter. It's just an ID. Sort of like your social security number. It don't really mean nothing to it. Right? It don't matter. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Because we dropped that sign. Once again, that's us fumbling the ball when it comes to us dealing with our kids. And I'm honest with them. Right? But like I said, I try to, you know, with the kids, I try to challenge them for the definition of their names. And if they don't have a definition, I challenge them to create, you know, a definition that they can get up in the mirror and say every day. You know what I'm saying? Because the name is basically like a program that you're able to follow, family. You know what I'm saying? It's so much shit that we have to. We have to really, really sit down and chop it up about. You know what I'm saying? We got to, you know what I'm saying? And we're not running out of time. I don't believe that shit. I believe we're falling farther and farther behind the rest of the world. I understand that I gotta find an article, but I'm understanding that the statistics say that black folks in 2016 our earnings have fallen below black folks in 2000. Now, what's crazy is that the motherfuckers was earning money in 2000 is the same motherfuckers that was earning money in 2016, and they saying that with if you adjust the income, black folks fell off. And by the way, how the hell do you don't matter? I don't understand. You know, I be talking so fast, but I'm preparing to fight. I'm preparing to fight the Uberman. You know what I'm saying? Who would win between Superman and God? You know what I'm saying? We already know it's a foregone conclusion. You know why? Because we are training our children to write the future story. That's what a lot of people slipping on, right? This is why it's important to understand what the fuck going on with Black Panther and what's going on with that show Confederate and what's going on with that show Black America. It's other people writing our story. And we need to stop that shit. You know what I'm saying? Freeze that shit. You know what I'm saying? Because other people are not allowed to tell our motherfucking story. They're not allowed. You know what I'm saying? They don't have permission. You know what I'm saying? You putting money in the pot. You know what I'm saying? Are you paying us? Are you funding shit from the money that you're getting from this? You know what I'm saying? When a motherfucker tell our story, regardless of whether it's a comic book or a motherfucking alternative history or whatever the fuck, and it involves black folks, you know what I'm saying? Motherfuckers supposed to be paying. I mean, really, that's taxes. You know what I'm saying? You are encroaching on our territory. Wakanda, because the shit is out there, and it's black people, and it's supposedly a mythic city, motherfuckers need to be paying taxes. I don't give a fuck if it's in the loop. I don't give a fuck. Pay me taxes. We need to have a black IRS shaking motherfuckers down. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Even some of these motherfucking rappers. Nigga, you rapping, talking about this stuff. Nigga, you know, break off some of the money that you will spend on the mollies. Break it off, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Really? Because that's how they get down. That's how everybody else get down. That's what countries do. Countries shake motherfuckers down. Oh, hey. I mean, homie, I see you. You getting big and shit. But you see these motherfuckers in green behind me? Right? You going to give or we going to take. That's exactly how the government rolls, family. We the only motherfuckers talking about, oh, give because it comes from the bottom of your heart. No. Russia ain't getting it like that. China ain't getting it like that. United States is not getting it like that. And black folks in America, we not gonna get it like that. Kwame says, speaking from a physics notion, matter is an aspect of that. That's right. That's right. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I mean, it's all one system. But we have been fooled to start separating into different shit, like a higher self and a lower self. I mean, I did that shit for years. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like the physical and the spiritual, and one is higher than the other, when in fact, you need all of it, or it don't work. Simple, right? It's common sense. But it ain't common. Why? Why? Because we have been traumatized. You know what I'm saying? We have been chasing illusions. You get fed illusions. Go and drink up with me so we get up out of here. You know, it's 5 o'clock in the morning. I got to get ready to go. Right? But I want to thank y'all for tuning in. Shouts out to Shishat Mayat. Shouts out to Brother Kwame. I'm going to knock out your 14 however many push-ups I owe you. You know, ever since that fast, man, I've been on rampage, eating like crazy, so hopefully I can knock out 14 push-ups. You know, I go from being able to knock out a lot of push-ups to not being able to do shit. You know what I'm saying? But I'm about to go on another fast, man. I want to do one. I got to work on it. I'm thinking in the new year. I'm going to do a fast for the 42 principles, 42 negative confessions, one per day. You know, I'm going to just go through our principles, but do a 42-day fast. I know how to do it now. Trust me on that shit. I know how to do it now. I know how to do it now. So, I ain't got to worry about that. But you know, sometimes I be kind of concerned that I go and do some extreme shit, then some shit pop off, and I have to go and get my weight back up, and I won't have time to get my weight back up for the battle, you know, because some of these young niggas, excuse my language, you know what I'm saying, on the battlefield, they need, you know what I'm saying, they gonna need some veterans out here, you know what I'm saying, some guys, some shit jump off, you know what I'm saying, whether we need to go hard, or we gonna need to do some strategical retreat. And let me say that to y'all, family, listen, in our stories that we make sure our children tell, we need to understand that we are a generation of people. We fight wars on generational time. This means like these motherfuckers have war for 4 or 5 years. We have wars like that, but we also have wars generationally, right? Right? So we will go into, in a sense, we fight over generations. So in a sense, we'll do a strategic retreat within ourselves, within our genome. So right now, this is what motherfuckers, warriors is coming back. They coming back. Warriors and generals, they coming back. Because we're generational people, like I told you. Right? This is why our ancestors always try to check. And people don't be looking at this. They try to check who this child is that is born to the family. This is why before we used to name children, before the trauma really set in. See, because the trauma was bad enough, and we was able to make it through the trauma. But when this rapid capitalism came in, and we started believing this rugged individual myth bullshit, it totally fucked us up. You know what I'm saying? Because you could drop crack into a real community, and crack will sit there. You drop crack into a place where a bunch of motherfuckers is about individuals and getting out and kicking it. Oh, you know what I'm saying? Not a real community. That shit's going to eat it up. But anyway, we're generational people. So in our story, we got to understand, and even deeper, this is part of this, one of the stories that I'm thinking about, right? Because that's all history is, right? I'm going to go as far as say that some of our ancestors set this shit up the way it is right now to wake our ass up. You know what I'm saying? Because these motherfuckers talk about secret societies, right? You know what I'm saying? What if the secret society that's running this shit look like you? I know that sounds crazy, right? But think about it. We were some wise motherfuckers, yo. I wouldn't put it past some of it. Like, yo, some shit coming. We need to get in front of this. You know, some of these soft-hearted motherfuckers ain't gonna be able to handle this, so we might have to let them see what they're gonna do. But how do we do that and not be destroyed? Well, you know, we're gonna do the secret shit. Where, you know what I'm saying? Where's our shit at? You know what I'm saying? I mean, I'm just saying, we're generational people. The generational people don't look at lifetimes. We look at spans of time. We look at hundreds and thousands of years. I'm just saying. But family, I'm about to go. I'm still looking forward to the day I get blocked on Facebook. Obviously, I'm not hitting enough nerves. So y'all have a great morning. I'm going to go out with some music. Oh, by the way, I want to send shots out. Yesterday, I went to the health fair put on by the Maroon Group. I saw the beautiful spot down there on Mount Vernon Avenue where Willoughby's Soul Veg is going to be. And they got like a little complex that's built using shipping containers. Shit is lovely. You know what I'm saying? And I'm hoping to bring back that festival, Coming Home Festival. You remember that shit? Because now they got an actual spot where people can actually gather and they could do a show right there in the center. You know what I'm saying? I want to send shots out to Tiffany Smith, a master jeweler from Sankofa Arts, making some beautiful shit. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's flying out the door. Tiffany Smith. You can hit her up at sankofaarts.com. Beautiful piece. Oh yeah, we're going to have a powerful day. I want to also send shouts out to brother, the Willoughby Soul Veg. You know what I'm saying? This is great. Alright, peace, Sister Shaq. You have a powerful day as well. Peace, Brother Carmen. I'm just doing my end of the show commercial. Take a day. Good fruit and strong roots. Carnell B. Willoughby, also known as Necessary, and Malik A. Willoughby. And they are the sole proprietor They could be contacted at willoughbysoulveg@gmail.com. All right? Willoughby spelled WILLOUGHBY. Get with those brothers. All right. So, with that, Brother Tim is out. And I wish y'all a great, a peaceful, powerful, and joyful day. And I also wish you 100 years. All right. And get some music on and we out. Let's see what we got.
Sacrifice. Those who died. Those whose bones lie deep in the Atlantic Ocean. Those ancestors stolen from the motherland and taken to another land. We honor you. I say. We honor those freedom fighters like Malcolm X, Marcus Garvey, Martin Luther King, Harriet Tubman, Mary Bethune, Nat Turner, and the thousands of others who fought, who bled, who died. I say, we honor those, the unknown warriors, whose names we don't know, who fought, who bled and died for freedom. As we pour and we say, I say. We honor the unborn children who will continue the legacy of sacrifice, who will fight in honor of those who fought the fight. I say. We call out to those, join the fight.
All right, family, we have technical difficulties, but that's I Share by D-Dad. We are out.